No. The book of Genesis, chapter 49, verse 1. And Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourselves together, that I may tell you that which may befall you in the last days.
So now this is Jacob, which is his, the name was changed to Israel. Are you familiar with the Bible, Lenny? You are familiar with the Bible? So you know who Jacob was? And what would you know, his name was changed to Israel? So Israel, he's the forefather of the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. My brother showed you that you was from the tribe of Benjamin. Let's read Benjamin, because this is where Judah was, this is where Jacob was about to die. So he was telling his sons what was going to happen. He was telling his 12 sons what was going to happen to them in the last days, which days we living in right now. Read that.
Genesis chapter 49, verse 27. Benjamin shall raven as a wolf.
So it says, Benjamin shall raven as a wolf. What are some of the characteristics of a wolf?
Bite.
They howl at the moon. You can hear them. If you're in an area where wolves at, when that moon come out, you hear them howling at the moon, right? So read.
In the morning, he shall devour the prey, and at night, he shall divide the spoil.
So when they say that Benjamin shall raven as a wolf, y'all listen to any reggae or Jamaican music? A little bit, y'all ever heard any of it? Like the lyrics of what they say? What are some of the things that they say in their music? You ever heard any of the music? A little bit. What are some of the things that they speak about in their music?
They refer to Jah.
They speak about the destruction of America.
Bring it out.
They speak about the destruction of the enemies. And when you read it again, read the whole verse.
Benjamin shall raven as a wolf.
Uh-huh.
In the morning, he shall devour the prey.
It says, in the morning, he shall devour the prey. Read.
And at night, he shall divide the spoil.
So when you look into the history in the West Indies, because in the West Indies, on them islands, they also were in captivity. They were also being oppressed. But it was a time in history where they actually fought against the oppressor and they actually won. They went into the mountains. How long have you been over here in America?
12 years.
12 years. What have you witnessed since you've been over here?
Huh?
What have you witnessed since you've been over here in this land?
Nowhere really.
No, I'm saying, what are some of the things you've seen in this? Because you live in this area?
Yeah.
You live in Dalton?
Yeah, right down there.
What have you seen since you've been living in Dalton? Going on amongst us in our community?
Crime.
You said destruction. You've seen those things. Why do you think that is? Because why do you think you end up living amongst crime? Your neighborhood is filled with crime. Why is that? Say it again. Exactly. We took on the characteristics of our oppressor. That's like you said that very eloquently. That was that, and that's correct. But listen to this. Give me Isaiah chapter 51 and 20. Because the reason that is, you are from the tribe of Benjamin, which is the kingdom of Judah. Read that in Isaiah 51 and 20. The reason that you live in a community where the things are down and bad is because we are the Israelites. You're living and seeing the curses. You're living and seeing what the Bible says is going to happen to the Israelites when we break God's commandments. Read that.
Isaiah 51 verse 20. Thy sons have fainted.
It says, thy sons have fainted. Now, in the Bible, who are the sons of God? We are. And what does the Bible say about it? How does the Bible, get that in Exodus 4 and 22.
Bring it out.
The Bible says, thy sons have fainted. When you faint, what happens? You fall out. You lose consciousness. Now that's the literal sense. But for us, it's in a spiritual sense.
Right.
Because now we're walking day in and out. We living. We conscious physically, but we don't know who we are. We don't know that we are the Israelites. We don't know that we are the gods of the earth. We don't know that we are supposed to be at the head of the nation.
Right. That's
we're
right.
Supposed to be ruling the world, but we're not. Read. We'll show you that.
Exodus chapter 4, verse 22. And thou shall say unto Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord, Israel is my son, even my firstborn.
So the Most High God calls Israel his son. His first. So the nation of Israel is God's sons. We are the sons of God.
That's right.
Read, go back to Isaiah 51.
Isaiah 51, verse 20. Uh-huh. Thy sons have fainted.
Uh-huh.
They lie at the head of all the streets.
What is considered the head of the street? Huh? You know what that is? The head considered the head of the street? The corner.
Right.
The corner, the main portion of any street is the corner. If you live on a corner house, you on the spotlight. Huh? Read it again.
Thy sons have fainted.
Uh-huh.
They lie at the head of all the streets.
They lie at the head of all the streets, meaning we are the ones standing on the corners of the blocks, selling weed, selling dope, plotting to do evil,
right.
Plotting to go and shoot somebody, rob somebody, kill somebody. And this is the Bible. The Bible is clear. It's talking about us. It hit it right on the head. Everything hit it right on the head of things that we do. Read.
As a wild bull in a net.
As a wild bull in a net. What happens when you put a bull in a net? If you put a net over a bull head, what's going to happen? Huh? He said go crazy. Would y'all agree with that? The bull is going to go crazy. What's going on in the streets of Chicago? The streets of Dalton? What's going on in these streets? The so-called black man, Hispanic man, they wild as a bull in the neck. Everybody, somebody bump your shoulder, you want to shoot them.
Bring it out.
Step on your shoes, now you fight. And they ain't even fighting no more, that's why there's so much shooting going on.
Bring it out.
Shooting is aimless because a lot of these young men that got guns don't even know how to handle the gun that they got. That's why babies get shot. Right?
Bring it out.
Because when they shoot at they op, so to say, they just shoot more aimlessly. They aiming like this. They aim at that white car and hit Burger King.
Right.
Bring it out.
That's a wild bull in the net. They wild. They got to jump out. You see the video. He jump out the car and shoots at the ground. He trying to hit the brother across the street, but he's shooting at the bullets you can see hitting the ground, and he ends up shooting the baby. That's a wild bull in the net. Read.
As a wild bull in a net, they are full of the fury of the Lord.
It said they are full of the fury of the Lord, meaning they are full of the curses of God. That's what this is talking about. The fury of the Lord are the curses. Because we go through these things because we are full of the fury of the Lord. What's your name, bro? Read that again.
Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets. As a wild boar in a net, they are full of the fury of the Lord.
They are full of the fury of the Lord. They are full of the curses of God. We, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, we turned our back on God. So we right now, we going to a disciplining stage. That's why there's so much murder and
streets
in the streets. Give me that in 1 Kings 8, because he asked the question. He said, how do we fix it? Right? How do we fix the problems in our community? How do we stop gang banging? What's the solution to the problem? What's the solution to our babies stop being shot and murdered and killed?
Fathers in
home. Fathers in home, that is a solution. Because for the father in fathers in home, that's the first step. But that father in the home got to be teaching his children laws.
Right.
He got to give them guidance according to the Bible.
That's right.
Read that.
The book of 1 Kings, chapter 8, verse 46. If they sin against thee.
So it says, if they sin against thee, referring to the Israelites. If they sin against thee, meaning if they break God's commandments or break God's rules, read.
For there is no man that sinneth not.
The whole nation of Israel have went off and broke God's commandments. That's why we in captivity today. Read.
And thou be angry with them.
And the Most High God be angry with us. We see that anger just like if you have a son. You got a son, my brother. My brother with the black hat. You got children? If your child do something, if you give your child instruction and he don't do what you told him to do, what's going to happen? You're going to discipline him. The same thing with the Most High God with us. Right now, we going through that discipline. That's why we are caught up in gangs. We walking down the street throwing up gang signs, throwing up GD, throwing up BD, fighting against each other, beefing with each other.
Organizations.
But those organizations are leading us away from our God.
Bring it out.
Those organizations are not teaching us the commandments of God.
Right.
It's leading us astray. Because we go to these games, why? A lot of times young men go to the game, why? Because his father wasn't at home.
Bring it out.
So he go to the game thinking that's some love. That's not love.
Hey.
That's not love. Money ain't a solution to nothing.
That's right.
Ain't nothing wrong with having money, but when you chasing it, that's something wrong.
You're
gonna do all type of evils to get that money.
That's why I'm standing right
here. I understand that. That's why I'm bringing it up. Read.
And thou be angry with them.
The Most High God was angry with us. Read.
And deliver them to the enemy, so that they carry them away captives unto the land of the enemy, far or near.
He said, so he carried them away captive to the land of the enemy, far or near. We were brought over here to America from the west coast of Africa on slave ships.
Right.
Our Native American Indian brothers, their land was conquered over here, and they were sent on slave ships to Europe. We suffer the same in Spain. We suffer the same curses. Same things happen to us. The conquistadors, exactly. Read.
Yet if they shall bethink themselves.
It says, yet if they shall bethink themselves. What's that, Baruch 2 and 30?
Yes.
Yep.
What is it? What does the word bethink mean? Huh? To rethink, what you think? What bethink? The word bethink.
Analyze.
What you have been analyzed to, colonialized to think.
No. What y'all think bethink mean?
It's like foresight.
You got it?
Baruch chapter 2, verse 30. For I knew that they would not hear me, because it is a stiff-necked people.
Uh-huh.
But in the land of their captivities.
So in the land of their captivities, read.
They shall remember themselves.
They shall remember themselves.
That's right.
But think yourself is to remember who you are.
That's right.
What's happening right now. Y'all hearing this because y'all, it's a plot. You remembering that we are. You hearing the words to kick your brain back and like, dang, that's me. That's my Bible. That's my history. You remember who you are. Go back to 1 Kings.
The book of 1 Kings, chapter 8, verse 47. Yet if they shall bethink themselves.
Yet if they shall remember who they are. Remember that they are Israelites. Remember they are the gods of the earth. Read.
In the land whether they was carried captives, and repent.
And repent. Remember, meaning we're going to remember who we are in the land that we were carried captive.
Yes,
we still in the land of America. We were carried over here captives.
Right.
And we're remembering who we are. We're calling ourselves the Israelites. We're coming back to our true heritage. We're coming back to our true nationality.
That's right.
Remembering who we are. And it says, and once we remember who we are, we must repent. Meaning stop doing the evil that you're doing. Stop breaking the commandments. Start studying the Bible and applying it. You have to repent. Feel remorse for the evils that you have done. Feel remorse for committing fornication. Feel remorse for gang banging, fighting your brother, shooting and killing your brother down in the streets. You gotta getting tattoos, shaving off your beard, stepping out on your wife. Repent. Feel remorse for those things. Read.
And make supplications unto thee in the land of them that carry them captives.
And when you do all that, you make supplication unto the Most High God. I mean, you send up prayers. You send up a request to God to forgive you. Read.
Say, we have sinned.
And you acknowledge that sin. You acknowledge the sin that you have been living in. Read.
And have done perversely.
And the wickedness that you have lived all your life. From 30, 40, however old you are. All the wickedness that you've learned living in this land, you admit. I've done perversely. I hated your laws. I hated your Bible. I turned my back on what you put in me.
Right.
Read.
We have committed wickedness.
Uh-huh.
And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul.
And when you send forth that prayer of repentance, now you search the Bible with your heart and you seek to apply the commandments that you have once broke, that you've once broken. Read. Exactly.
This comes from the white man.
It comes from a white man, exactly. Read.
And the land of their enemies which led them away captives and prayed.
Read that again.
And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul in the land of their enemies which led them away captives.
So it says we return unto God with all our heart and with all our soul. Hold that and get Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Because he said we return unto him with all our heart and all our soul. What does it mean to return unto him? My brother, what's your name in the black?
Murph.
Okay. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12. And now, Israel, what doeth the Lord thy God require of thee?
What does God require of the Israelites? What is the requirement that's on our head? Y'all have heard, y'all understand, y'all are the Israelites. The word has came to y'all. What's required of you now that you're an Israelite? Read.
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways, mm-hmm. and to love him, and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart.
This is, remember, these words is the same when we just read in 1 Kings 8. Same thing. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart. Read.
And with all thy soul, to keep the commandments of the Lord.
To keep the commandments. So to return unto the Lord with all your heart and soul is to return unto his commandments. Read.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day for thy good.
And his commandments is for our good. You grow your beard because you grow your beard because one is a base. Donovan says a beard is a badge of manly dignity. Your beard is a sign of your manhood.
That's
so
right.
We walk the streets and cut our beard off.
Right.
And look like little boys. Why grow up and get an age and then shave your beard off so you can look like a boy?
Right.
That don't make no sense. That's backwards.
That's right.
But that's the way, like you said, that's the ways of our oppressor. That's the ways of the white man. You look like a pedophile when you shave your beard off, you look like a pedophile. Read. Huh? Exactly. Go back to 1 Kings.
Verse 48. And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul.
Uh-huh.
In the land of their enemies, which led them away captives, and pray unto thee towards their land.
So we're going to do these things in the land that we were carried captives. We were the so-called blacks. We were carried captives over here to the land of America. We waking up. So we're going to start keeping the commandments in this land. Read.
Which thou gavest unto their fathers.
Uh-huh. And we're going to pray towards our land. Our land is Jerusalem. Get that in Galatians 4. Our land is Jerusalem, which is towards the east. The land of Israel, that's our land. It's not those Jewish people, the fake Jews that's over there. That's not their land. They living in our land right now. They imposters.
That's right.
Galatians chapter 4, verse 26. But Jerusalem, which is above, is free.
So Jerusalem, which is above, means it's above all other nations. It's above all other land masses. Read.
Which is the mother of us all.
Jerusalem is the motherland, which is in the northeast corner of Africa.
That's right.
Go back to 1 Kings. Read.
1 Kings chapter 8, verse 48. And so return unto thee with all their heart and with all their soul in the land of their enemies, which led them away captives. And pray unto thee towards their land,
uh-huh.
which thou gavest unto their fathers.
So the land of Israel was given to our fathers, and that's what we pray towards. Read.
The city which thou hast chosen,
uh-huh.
and the house which I have built for thy name.
Read.
Then hear thou their prayer.
So it says, only then when we repent, remember who we are, we repent and we start applying the commandments, then and only then will the Most High God hear our prayers. Anything else other than that, you're not keeping the commandments, your prayers are getting answered by the devil.
That's right.
Your prayers are being answered by Satan. You ain't getting no blessings from God
if you're not
keeping his commandments.
That's right.
Read.
Then hear thou their prayer and their supplication in heaven, thy dwelling place,
uh-huh.
and maintain their cause.
And it says maintain their cause, meaning the Most High God gonna fight for us when we keeping his commandments.
That's right.
We keeping his commandments, he gonna protect us from the evils that's going on. He gonna be a shield to us because we keeping his commandments. We doing just like a father. You got children, something happened to your son, what's gonna happen? Somebody come up, you got sons, somebody come up and do something to your son, what's gonna happen? You're gonna deal with them the same way the Most High God feel about us. But you gotta be in line, you gotta be in order, you gotta be doing what he say to do.
That's right.
Because right now, the streets of Dalton, the streets of Chicago, Harvey, all of these cities, we not doing what God told us to do. That's why it's trouble in the neighborhood.
Yes.
Because believe it or not, we gonna get through, is that it on that?
That's it.
Give me Deuteronomy 32 and 39, then we're going to go to 1 Corinthians 3 and 16. Deuteronomy 32 and 39, because believe it or not, all these shootings and killings is orchestrated by the Most High God.
Bring it out!
Because ain't nothing done on this earth without God giving the permission for it to be done.
That's right.
Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 39. See, now that I am he,
uh-huh.
and there is no God with me.
So the Most High saying, ain't nobody on my level. I'm God. I'm the creator of the world. Ain't no Buddha, ain't no God. Islam ain't no God, ain't none of that stuff. Those are idols. They don't exist. They falsehoods. Read. He said, I kill. The Most High God said, I kill. Ain't none of the killings that's going on. It's the Most High God. Why? Because we're breaking His commandments. Read.
And I make alive.
He said, I kill and I give life. Read.
I wound.
I wound. That's why our brother can get shot and then come out the hospital and survive. Because the Most High God ordained. He gave you a chance to get yourself right. Read.
And I heal.
And I heal. It's the Most High God that's in control of all.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.